Hi everyone and welcome to our YouTube channel IT Support, and today we are going to learn about configuring remote block storage. So what is remote block storage? So have you heard about sharing the file into the network? And that is only possible with NFS and the Samba. But if you want to share a particular block into the network, that is also possible with SCSI storage into the network, so that the client machine can access the particular block of storage as a local storage. So suppose here we have one SCSI server and there are a number of SCSI disks are attached to this server, so that this we can share into the network. And that disk will be work as a local disk for this client. So that we are going to learn today. So let's start with the type of storage. So first is the direct attached storage. So in this type of storage, the hard disk is locally attached to the system. So suppose this is your laptop and hard disk is connected inside this laptop will be the direct attached storage. And the second type is network attached storage, that is called NAS, or storage area network, that is called SAN. These are the storage server where number of hard disks are connected, and that server is connected to LAN where the local machine can access the disk inside this storage server. So if one of the machine goes down, then it will not affect the storage because the storage is inside the server. So the second client can access the same storage from the machine. Suppose one of the user is sitting in this machine and this machine goes down, so that user can sit into this machine and he can access his data from the storage server. So that configuration we are going to learn in this session, so that this particular disk will be available into the network and the client can access. So iSCSI is an internet small computer system interface. It can be used as a direct storage, direct attached storage, or network attached storage. Why it is used in network attached storage? Because it is work, it is support IP based storage networking, and it can be used for data transfer over internet and to manage storage over long distance. These are working with the fiber channel. That's why iSCSI is used into the network attached storage, and it is also very inexpensive. So block level access for shared storage, it provides the block level access for the shared storage, where NFS and Samba provide file level access for the storage. So the storage on the remote server will be called as a target, and protocol allows client to access will be initiated. So the client we can call it, the client will be work as an initiator, and the server where the storage will be available is called target. So let's start to configure the environment into our lab. So here we are going to configure one machine as a target server and one machine as a initiator. So the server name will be turret, its IP will be 192.168.1.145, and the package we are going to install to make this server as a target server will be target CLI. In the host name will be Churchill, its IP will be 1.144, and the package that we are going to install to make this machine as an initiator is iSCSI initiator utils. So after configuring the target server and initiator, we will going to start communication. So before installing the target package, we need to make available one of the disk to be share into the network. So we have created one of the disk that is /dev/sdb. Okay, so inside this disk we have created one partition that is called sdb5, and that partition is LVM. Okay, so that LVM we are going to share from this SCSI target server, and that will be accessed by the initiator. So let's see the server configuration. So in the server configuration, prerequisites are to have a partition or that block partition that we are going to share. And after installing the target CLI package, we can start, we should start that target service and enable the target service. After installing target CLI, we can fire the command as a target CLI to go inside the target shell. So the target CLI will be used as an administration shell for storage target, and target CTL save and restore configuration of the target. So after typing the command target CLI, you will get the target CLI interactive shell, where if you type command ls, you will get this information, you will get the disk table. So let me show you my server and the client machine, then we will go with this all configuration. So here, I'm having my server that is turret. So here you can see the host name is turret. Okay, and this is my CentOS Linux 7, and IP address is 192.168.1.145. And if I do lsblk command, then here you can see this is my first disk and this is my second disk. Inside this second disk I have two partition, sdb1, which is extended partition, and inside extended partition I have created one partition as a logical partition, that is sdb5, and inside this sdb5 I have created one volume group, that is iSCSI VG, and inside that volume group I have one logical volume which is of size 1 GB, and this the size of this partition is 5 GB. Okay, so let me show you about the client. So this is my client. So here you can see the host name is Churchill. This operating system is the same operating CentOS Linux 7. IP address is 1.144. LSBLK. So here you can see I have only one disk and three partition, SDA1, SDA2, SDA3. So let's start with the server. Install the So as you can see, target CLI is already installed. So let me type the command target CLI. If you type the command target CLI, then it will show you target CLI shell version 2.1, and I'm inside the target CLI shell. If you will do the command ls, it will also work in target CLI. So here you can see some of the things, that is back stories. These are the information about the back stories. These are the storage information inside the target server, and this contain the block, file IO, PSCSI, RAM disk, SCSI, and the loopback. So these four are the disk information, and this is the SCSI information that we are going to configure in this server. So let's see what these are. So as you see, a block is the device defining on the server, such as the disk drive, disk partition, logical volume that we are going to use into the server to share with initiator. Also the file IO is creating any file as a disk, like image file to be storage for virtual machine disk image. So here we are making any file as a disk, and then we are going to share that file. Then PSCSI are the physical SCSI connected to the target server. This is a physical SCSI, and that we need to define here. Also the RAM disk, this is the suppose you have any client machine where you need a temporary data to be stored, and once the server restarted or rebooted, that data will get vanished. So in that type of configuration, you can create a RAM disk, so where the data will be stored persistently. If server is rebooted, all data will be lost. And the iSCSI section, under this we have to provide configuration for iSCSI, like IQN, TPG, ACL, LUN, that is LUN portal. So what is IQN that we are going to define under the iSCSI? IQN is an SCSI qualified name. This will be the SCSI qualified name, a worldwide unique name used to identify both initiator and the target. This will identify the target storage and the initiator in the metadata naming format. So this is the naming format for iSCSI. Okay, it is like fully qualified domain name where it will be identified into the network. Same way here we are creating IQN for SCSI device. Then TPG is the target portal group, is a set of interface IP and a port on which iSCSI target will listen. So here we are going to define IP address and the port number on which the target will be listen, target server will listen. ACL, an access control list to validate access permission for initiator. So here you can define the access control list for initiator who is going to access the target. LUN is a logical unit number that is assigned to the device attached and available through the target. So that is the LUN number is assigned to the target the device that is going to be accessed from the target. The portal here, the portal is the IP and port number on target or initiator to establish the connection. IP address and port number on target or initiator to establish the connection, that all we are going to configure in target server. fine. So let's start to configure. First is the block, and here we are using the block name as a server disk dev, and this is here I written the two times, but it is actually one time, and this is a virtual group name and this is the LV name. So let's start to configure. After configuring block, we need to create IQN. So this is the IQN name for the SCSI, that is SCSI into the target, which will uniquely identify it into the network. After that, we are going to create ACL for IQN for initiator. This is the address for the initiator and this is for server. This is ACL for initiator. After that, LUN for disk. This block, we are going to use this block and create a logical unit number for the shared block. After that, we are going to define the portal and create the IP address of the server where the initiator will make a connection and will listen, and the target will listen. And after that, we will do ls and we'll check the configuration. After checking configuration, if we do exit, we will get out from the target CLI shell, and it will show the message that global preference auto save on exit true. So it will automatically save this configuration, and last config save in the configuration will be saved in this path slash etc target backup and configuration save to, and this is the configuration where it is save. And after configuring the target, we will going to configure SCSI initiator. So to configure SCSI initiator, we have to install the package iSCSI initiator util as we discussed earlier, and where we have to go in the file slash etc SCSI initiator name dot SCSI, where you will find the IQN number for IQN name for the client machine where it was default, and we have to change with this. Okay, so let's start to do this configuration on server. So I have a set of command. So first we are going to create disk 1. So the command will be slash back storage. If you type the tab, it will autocomplete. Then B tab. Then type the command create. Then name. If you not type and again press tab, then it will show you the option name read only EWH. So here we are going to use name. So the name is server dot disk 1 and dev, then SDB 5. It's iSCSI VG name, the virtual group name, and then LV name. If you press enter, so it will show you the message created block storage object server. This is the object block that is created using this logical value. If you press ls, then here you can see block is having this server.disk1 and ALUA, this is already defined for this server. So the second command will be for iSCSI. So we configure the back storage, then we have to go inside the iSCSI. So to go inside the iSCSI, just press slash iSCSI and then create the iSCSI IQN. So the IQN is IQN.2017. So it will be the year, after that the month. This is the format to create the IQN for the machine. Then com, and this, that is your domain name that you have already, so that you can use. I'm going to use itsupport.com, and turret. Okay, if you press enter, so here it will be showing you the create target. The target is created with the name and created TPG, as we have discussed what is TPG. So when it is already created, global preference auto add default portal true, and created default portal listening. So this is the default portal 4x0 port 326. This is the default port that is listen for iSCSI. If you do ls, you can see inside iSCSI IQN is created and its name is okay. Then TPG1 is already created. ACL we need to define, learn we have to define, and portal we have to define here. So the ACL learns and learns and portals are coming inside this TPG1. Okay, to configure ACL we have to go first inside the iSCSI, then IQN. After IQN you need to go in TPG1. After inside TPG1 you have to type A, then tab ACLs, and then you need to define ACL. You need to create ACL, create an ACL for IQN of the initiator, IQN name of the initiator, that will be 2017 and the month is 09 .com.itsupport:Churchill. Fine, this is the IQN name of the initiator. If I press enter, so ACL for this IQN is created. If you do ls, you can see ACL for this is created and this is mapped. So let's start to create LUNs. To create LUN, again you have to go inside iSCSI IQN TPG and then LUNs, and inside LUNs create and the name of this server.disk. So it will be back storage, so here you need to type B as a back storage server block. It will automatically take, press enter. So LUN 0 mapping in node IQN is created. You do ls, you can see LUN is already created. LUN is created. Then you need to define the portal. So to configure portal, you have to go inside iSCSI. TPG portals. Create. Then the IP address 192.168.1.145, and the port number it will take by default 3260. You press enter using default IP port 3260. Could not create network portal in config 5, so inside it that is not created, but you can see IP is not taken. So go inside iSCSI IQN TPG portal, create 192.168.1.145. So it is giving me the error that could not create network portal in config fs. So let me check. So let me try to delete this first and then create. So what is it? iSCSI IQN, then TPG, then portals, then delete 0.3260, press enter, deleted, and then create. .145 and the port number 3260, press enter. Okay, so created the portal. If you do ls, so all setting is done from server side. So let's start to create initiator. If you do exit, so what it will do, it will automatically save the configuration inside this file. Let me show you what these files are. cd/utc target. If you go inside it, if you do ls, you can see there are two files. Backup is storing here and the configuration inside this file. If you go inside the backup ls, so this is the configuration save inside it. If you do so you can do cat for save config. This is a program to automatically save the configuration from target CLI. So let's go into the client machine. Inside client, we need to install the iSCSI initiator utils. Let me copy this command that we are going to use inside the client machine. This is my client machine. So first install the target initiator package. So it is showing that iSCSI initiator utils already installed latest version. So let's check the default IQN name for initiator. If you do vim/utc iSCSI, there you will find iSCSI for file. Then you have to go initiator name. If you press enter, you will see IQN name. Default IQN name is already present here. While after installing the package, this IQN is already defined here. And this is of 194, it's the fifth month. So let's do it, make it as IQN, our custom IQN name. Remove it, paste, and then save. After saving, start and enable iSCSI D. Is the daemon service. So we have started the iSCSI D and enable the iSCSI D. After that, we are going to do lsblk to check. So here I'm having only one disk that is locally attached to the system, and then we are going to attach the shared storage. So for that the command is iSCSI ADM hyphen M. You can do a man for iSCSI. So here you will find the option hyphen M discovery to discover the target. So here hyphen T is used to discover the target and P as a portal for IP address 145. So here you can see M is used with every option. So what is the meaning of M? Let's see here. So M is the mode, is the iSCSI ADM mode where we are searching the option, and option L as a login hyphen T. Let me show you the option T. So it is a type of it is showing that the type send target, and small p is portal and the IP address of the portal. So let's fire this command iSCSI ADM hyphen M discover. Let me copy this command and paste. You press enter. So this command will discover the IQN name that is available into the network, and here I can see 192.168.1.145. This is the portal with the port number. So the target is listening on this IP and port number, and its IQN name is IT support direct. So here we can successfully find out the target in our network. So let's to mount this target. So L means small L means we are going to log in, and here we use a node, the target IQN name. So I feel capital T is defined for target name and IQN name. So let's copy this command and paste here. If you press enter, so you got successfully logged in. And if you do lsblk command, so here you can see SDB with the shared GB, 1 GB is successfully available, and it is available into this machine. Now you can create a partition, and then you can mount and start using the shared storage. Fine. So this is how we configure the remote block storage into the network, and that block is used by the initiator, that is client machine, as a local disk. So here it is working as a local disk. So the advantage of using this configuration is that data security. Suppose you have a number of PC that is out of your network, means out of your office, and you have your data center inside the office, and that is locked inside the room. So anyone can access that storage, but physically no one can touch the server. So this is increase the security to your data, because no one can go inside the data center and no one can remove the disk from the server. Also the data is protected inside the server, so there is no data theft issue inside the local machine that you are using in your laptop. So this is how it is available into the client machine. So thank you for watching this video. If you like our video, you can subscribe us, and you can also like my videos. Thank you. Bye bye.